Hi there. In this video I'm going to attempt to fix this LED flashlight. It's quite a beefy one. I think it's... where are the watts? 10 watts. It has a 10 watts LED. Decent. Normally it was water resistant, not waterproof. I think only rain resistant and stuff like that, but as you can see here, yeah, that began to break. And why they didn't use something like a silicone or something that doesn't break, I don't know. Anyway, let's try and fix it. At least if I cannot fix it, get some parts out of it. So yeah, first thing, this doesn't have any obvious screws. For sure it has one in here, maybe here, and probably some in here somewhere. But that doesn't really help us. As if we look carefully, this thing is not made from two parts. This is not a line where you can split this in two. This is just a parting line from the mold that made this thing. And if you look at it like this, all the chamfers are like that. So this is how they opened up the mold. Yeah, no chances of going that route. So I'm expecting this is closed when you put this thing on from this end. So I tried to rotate it. Yeah, doesn't do anything. I will try just to pry it out, and it already has some big cracks in this area. Camera, focus. Please focus. Okay. So it might break when I try to open it up. Whoa, what was that? But anyway, that's about it. Nothing else that I can do. So let's see some high speed opening up or destruction. Depends on what happens next. And I got more than I expected. This thing is really nice quality. Seems to have an 18650 cell inside of it or something like that, which I am going to, this popped out a bit too easy, I am going to take out and put it on my tester and see if it's any good anymore. And if it's not, I have 2000 milliamp hours, but this is probably not the exact type that you find in a laptop. This, from what I see, might actually have a protection on it. The ones from the laptop, normally the electronics does all the protecting, so I wouldn't just put one from a laptop inside this thing. But I think I have one from another flashlight. Maybe I actually have to. Anyway, I need to search a bit and see what I can get. But first, let's put this one on the tester and see. Maybe it's not even bad. Who knows? Maybe something else is damaged, or this over discharged, and the protection kicked in, and that is why it's not charging anymore. Let's pop it into the charger and see what we actually get. Number one, random. Number two. I try to use all of them randomly. So at first sight, this thing is not loading. So probably the protection actually kicked in. So this thing needs a good jump start. I know how to do that. Be back in a second. And here I present you the jump start starter kit. A really weak, maximum 300 milliamp hours charger, and I suspect it's even weaker than that. I set it to 3 volts or maximum 4.5, but it will not give us 3 or 4.5. In 4.5 position, it will barely give 3 volts, probably. It's that weak. So it has no chance of blowing up this battery, no matter what I try. This thing is just unable, doesn't have enough current. Normally I work with laptop batteries. Oh, sorry for that loud noise. And those have some tabs on them, so it's quite easy with this to attach to the tabs. This one, well, it does not. So I need to figure out something else. Let's plug this thing in. And probably I will simply hold it in place until this thing gets enough juice to remove the protection by itself. Let's see. Okay, this is on. I should stop it before I short it. Let's check the cell at this point. Let's go to 20 volts. What? Did this thing just break on me? No, I just wasn't in a good position to rotate it. Absolutely zero. And yes, I want to add that there are many people that say when this thing is over discharged, it's Gansky. Probably, what am I doing? Did you see how big of an idiot I was? I was testing with this thing. Okay, so it has some sort of voltage. Ah, what an idiot. Sorry about that. So some say that if this gets over discharged, you should just recycle it, not try to use it anymore. Well, a channel that I quite like on YouTube. Let's start this and test how much voltage it gives at 4.5, but this is without a load. What? Nah, for sure. Without a load. Anyway, Big Clive, I think the channel is. Not sure. Maybe he has even a website, biglife.com. Anyway, he did some tests and he says, reality, these things actually are not that weak, and most of them can actually be saved even when they get to this low of a voltage, if the inside of them is not damaged. So if it is damaged, they will heat up when you try to charge them. So again, recycle them. But if you monitor them really carefully, they do not overheat. They don't show any signs of really fast discharging. These things can be saved. So this is what I'm trying now. I've saved a few laptop cells. Honestly, all of them could be saved. But yeah, probably sooner or later I will find one that cannot be saved. So let's see what we got. Did we at least raise the voltage enough? Where is this thing? Nope, we did not. Let's not short these wires. Yeah, I will do this in high speed. At this point, I need to check the voltage once again and see if we raised it at least a tiny bit. And you can see we are at 1.6 volts from 0.2. So the voltage is clearly increasing while I hold these things on it, and make sure you get the polarity right. I know for a fact that this is positive. Yeah, so this will take a few minutes. I'm not going to fully charge it like this. I know this is not how you charge a lithium cell. It's way different from nickel cells, but anyway, this is how I jumpstart them. So let's do this in high speed. And as you could see, it's recognized and it started to charge it. What I'm thinking at this point, this has a 10 watts LED. For the charger, it says 5 volts, 1 amp. In reality, probably in the battery, we are getting 5 volts. Oh no, we are not actually getting 5 volts. We are getting less than that, but maybe 1 amp, maybe 0.8, maybe 0.9. Anyway, I am going to charge it. Actually, not only charge it, sorry about that. I am going to test it. Let's focus on this thing. Normal test at 1 amp. And then it will do a discharge What it does in normal test, it fully charges it to the max with 1 amp, 1 milliamp hour. 1 amp hour, Jesus, my brain is fried today, I'm a bit tired. Then it will discharge it fully to see how much it actually held within, and then fully charge it back so it's ready to use for you. This, I'm not sure I really like the internal resistance. It seemed to be a bit high, but I've seen this in the past, and if I remove it and connect it back, sometimes these weaker cells, yeah, it actually changes. When it has a really low voltage, that value seems to be a bit high. If this one would be 500, then I would think this battery is fried, but for sure it's not. Let me just try it again. Yeah, at this moment it's high again. Probably it will again show a high value. Yeah, even higher. So I need to let it charge in its state at 1 amp, do a full test and see what we get. And it will draw from it, what will it draw? 500 milliamp hours? I think that it's the current draw, but this thing is able to draw more than 2 amps for sure from it. So this is not quite as strong as that for testing, but anyway, should give us an idea if this battery is good or not. So yeah, this will take a few hours. What am I talking about? Probably I will know tomorrow morning the real capacity of this. So that's when the video will continue. And this is what we got after the test. The original capacity should be 2000 milliamp hours, and we get this, which isn't awesome, but isn't extremely bad either. This has probably about 65% of the original capacity left, if not 70, but I think 65 is about right. So anyway, I'm going to try and use it and see what we get. Normally this should still work. It shouldn't hold too much, but should still work. So yeah. Okay, so I've put the battery in. And let's just give it a quick test. Press the button. Voila! Even the red light at the end of it, it's working. So this thing just needed to be jump started. I've seen this way too many times on lithium powered devices. Of course I will give it a few charges and see how it works, but I'm expecting it to be perfectly functional from what I've seen in the past. Let me just try to plug this thing in here to make sure it doesn't allow the battery to jump out. And now let's put this thing back together. And if you look at this, normally you plug it in and rotate it so it locks in there, so it doesn't need to be pried out like I did, but it's really damn hard to rotate this thing, so hopefully I can do it. Okay, it's quite nice that this thing also shows you how much charge it has left, and it has LEDs for charging this one and full that one. So what I need to find now, it's about 5 volt charger at about 1 amp. And first let me see if I can remove this rubber somehow. Maybe it's glued in here, could be. Anyway, then I will try just to put a bit of scotch tape over this thing and see if I can hold this in place, and in case that doesn't work, I will try to put this button in there. But this is my second option. I'm trying to use the scotch tape to hold this in place. I don't know if it will work, but Let's try. Managed to pry this thing out. It's quite easy to put it back, so that is perfect. I'm going to use this roll of it and then nicely cut it around this shape and see what we get. Maybe it's really bad, maybe it's perfect. We'll see that in a moment. This is how it looks with the first layer. Obviously it's not perfect, but it does what it should do. And I'm going to cut it nicely all around between the label and the plastic, and then put the second layer just to make it a bit stronger. And I'm thinking this is good enough. And I've cut this in some lines, so this little thingy can actually go in. And I'm not sure, I think it was like this, but I think I will put it like this. Seems easier to me to open it from that side. Maybe it even was like that, I just remembered wrong. So let's get that thing in. And this looks like it will work for a while. There is not enough movement in this scotch tape to make it break too soon. Good enough for me. So let me search for a charger and put some super glue on this big crack right here. It doesn't seem to be affecting anything, but I don't want pieces of it falling out, because you can see I can move it with my finger. So let's do that now. Yeah, so the only charger that I found is this little guy. 6 volts, 1 volt higher. I don't think it will create issues. 500 milliamps. That's about half of what we need. This could get a bit hot. So I will do a few tests, full discharge, recharge with this, and see if it gets too hot or it's good enough. Normally this would need a 5 watt charger, and this only has 3 volt amps. So yeah, but anyway, this is again the only one that I have, and even the plug fits really nicely in here. So you know me, I use what I have, but safety first. So I will do a few tests. And this glued together with super glue, it's almost dry now, it will not fall apart. Yeah, and I don't have the original charger. I got this from some friends. They wanted to throw it away because it wasn't doing anything anymore. So the fact that it powers on shows us the power and works, maybe even charges. For me, that's a plus. Now this is really weird. How did this thing end up having the wrong polarity? As you can see, it should have positive on the inside and negative on the outside, and it doesn't, and these are in their proper position. So it has exactly the opposite polarity that it's written on it should have. So this thing obviously will not charge because it's the wrong polarity. Hopefully it didn't blow up internally, but I think it had some diode protection, at least because no smoke was released. This is extremely weird. What I'm thinking, that maybe somebody opened this thing up and put the wires backwards. They needed the opposite polarity for something. Okay, let's open this thing up. And yes, there are safety screws on it. They suck. Yep, for sure, somebody had a go at this thing. That is why we have the wrong polarity. They needed to reverse it for something. So let me unsolder this little wire here and solder it back the right way, the original way. Now we're talking. This thing is charging. So, yep, we have fixed it. Again, the flickering is not in real life. This flickering is in real life. So that's about it for this video. What can I say? I'm glad we managed to fix this thing. Quite nicely built. I don't consider it waterproof or rainproof really at this point, but I don't know, random tiny splash proof, yeah, should be still okay for it. So that's about it. Again, thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed this video. In which case, maybe please give it a like, check out my other videos, subscribe to my channel, all the good stuff. And yeah, as always, see you in the next one. Bye.